Hello everyone. I am sure that you are aware by now that we are currently living in an unprecedented time such as we have never experienced before. Locked in our own homes, having nothing to do, wondering what's going to happen tomorrow. But I want to encourage you this morning. I want to share a few thoughts to exhort and encourage you during this time of crisis. The entire world, as you all know, is being shaken right now. And governments all over the world are perplexed because they do not know how to curb this epidemic, this pandemic that is going around from nation to nation. The economies of the world are reeling from the impact and the fear this virus is spreading. And of course, the church of the Lord Jesus Christ is also being shaken. Many, many buildings are closed down. We cannot gather together to worship the Lord. Times such as we have never seen before. Everything that can be shaken is being shaken right now. And you know what? I'm reminded of the words that are written in the book of Hebrews chapter 12. And I'm going to read to you verse 26, 27, and 28. This is what it says. Yet once more, I shake not only the earth, but also heaven. Now this yet once more indicates the removal of those things that are being shaken as of things that are made, that the things which cannot be shaken may remain. Therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom which cannot be shaken, let us have grace by which we may serve God acceptably with reverence and godly fear. Let me clarify something here. God is not the author or the cause of this pandemic, but He will certainly use this situation and bring many to Him in this hour. And in Him, they will find refuge, salvation, and comfort. I perceive that through this shaking that the world is experiencing right now, many will turn to the Lord because this shaking will awaken them from their spiritual slumber. Even the church will be forced to reevaluate where we stand and what we believe, and we should. Comforts and privileges of the past are falling away, and we are forced to reconsider many things which we have deemed precious and valuable. In this hour of trial, we need to look beyond ourselves and rise to the challenge and to the aid and to the help of a hurting world. The words given to Esther by Mordecai keep ringing in my ears. Yet who knows whether you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this? Be aware, be prepared to be stirred by the Holy Spirit to act on our Heavenly Father's behalf, tangibly helping those in need at this time. This could be the church's finest hour where we truly reflect and represent our loving Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. There could be, these of course could be the days in which scores of people will come to repentance and faith in Jesus Christ. Some out of desperation, while others through loss and much suffering. Let us be ready to welcome them, ready to stand in the gap on the behalf of the land and on the behalf of the people who desperately need encouragement and comfort right now. And let me remind you once again that we are part of a kingdom that cannot be shaken. Therefore, let us have grace by which we may serve God acceptably with reverence and godly fear. God's kingdom will never be shaken. The word of God will never be shaken. And those who trust in God's word will never be shaken. Psalm 112 says that the man who fears the Lord and greatly delights in His commandments will never be shaken. He will not be afraid of evil tidings because his heart is fixed, steadfast, trusting in the Lord. His heart is established. He will not be afraid. So I want to encourage you today. Let your heart take comfort and be established in God's eternal promises. Those who stand on God's word, those who believe the word of God from the heart, those who decree and declare the word of God will stand and will not be shaken. They will be shielded and not be destroyed. God bless you.